Well, they were actually brigaded together in October of 1861 under a guy by the name of Rufus King. And the brigade consisted of four regiments from the West. It is the only brigade in the entire Army of the Potomac that was from the West. The 2nd Wisconsin had been engaged at the Battle of First Bull Run. The other regiments of the brigade, which include the 6th and the 7th Wisconsin and the 19th Indiana, were actually not engaged in combat till the Battle of Bronner's Farm, which is part of the 2nd Manassas Campaign. Said they will have all four of those regiments, two in advance and two behind the other, advancing south on the east side of the Hagerstown Pike, and they're going to be taking incoming artillery and infantry fire from the west on their flank. So what John Gibbon will do, he will take two of those regiments, the 19th Indiana and the 7th Wisconsin, across to the west side of the Hagerstown Pike. So they will be advancing in unison with the two regiments that are on the east side, which is going to be the 6th Wisconsin and the 2nd Wisconsin. They will move through the cornfield. They will get to the southern edge of the cornfield, and in all this time, they're going to be engaging the Confederate forces. They are going to be able to push Jackson's Confederates southward to within a couple hundred yards of the Dunker Church. So in that area, on both sides of Hagerstown Pike, they will actually, like I said, be the initial entity that breaks through Jackson's line and pushes it back. And what will happen with the Iron Brigade and the other regiments that are to their support, after they break through Jackson's line, John Bell Hood's command is going to come up and support Jackson. Hood's command will form in line of battle on the Smoketown Road. They are going to push north or northward. They'll push the Iron Brigade and those other Union regiments northward. And they will suffer a lot of casualties in that action. They will actually push several regiments of the Iron Brigade through the cornfield and into a swale that is to the north of that cornfield. After that point, John Gibbon is going to get some of those regiments to move over to the west side of the Hagerstown Pike to support the 6 guns of Battery B that are due west of the cornfield. So yes, they're engaged from about 6 o'clock in the morning till about 7:30, and they do suffer heavy casualties in that action. While they're going to withdraw, Battery B will withdraw with them, and they will spend the rest of the day up in the North Woods. I think they're actually going to be up there. They're going to be resupplied with ammunition, but they will not be engaged in the fighting for the rest of the day at Antietam. Well, the Iron Brigade got its name after the Battle of South Mountain. They were advancing westward after that battle, and supposedly I think Joseph Hooker and McClellan were watching them move, and the subject came up about them being pretty stout fighters, pretty good fighters, and the comment was made, well, those men are made of iron. And as McClellan purportedly wrote letters to the governors of Wisconsin and Indiana telling them, you know, about the fighting that they had done at South Mountain, and I think potentially including that comment in there about the men being made of iron. So it's after the Battle of South Mountain that they actually earned that moniker. Prior to that, they had been referred to, and actually after that, they were referred to as those damned black hats.